So I think it helps you to be involved more. But I think that's that dialogue should happen more often.
Okay, we've got stories now. Russell Wilson, I can tell you this, isn't happy with Pete Carroll. He likes his teammates. He likes Seattle. It's a Pete Carroll thing. The offense is outdated. Analytic people for several years now have rolled their eyes at the Seahawks offense. That's not my opinion. I've had three different Seattle players tell me they feel like they're running a 1980s offense. Since the death of Paul Allen, Pete Carroll has unquestioned power. In my opinion, it's a lopsided franchise where the coach has too much power over the playbook, has too much power over his quarterback, has too much power over the franchise, and too much power over John Snyder. The offensive line has been suboptimal since they traded away Max Unger, a very talented center, and Russ doesn't believe he is given the respect he deserves. And the bigger issue is, let's say Andy Reid was struggling with Mahomes. Andy Reid could still point to that offense and go, look what I'm doing. When Bill Belichick and Brady had their prickly moments, Belichick's defense was still great. What is happening in Seattle is the offense is outdated, but the defense is no good, and that's Pete's specialty. In the last 5 years, Seattle's defense has gone from 5th to 11th to 16th to 26th to 22nd. And too often, Russell Wilson feels like a life preserver for a franchise that can't stop anybody. And what you're having now, and I will say this, it is a little bit of a Tom Brady effect. Because Brady wins the Super Bowl, you got two things happening. Teams are now saying, oh, all we need is a quarterback. Just give us Carson Wentz and Matt Stafford. And that's happening. But here's the second thing that's happening. Guys like Russell Wilson are saying, the hell? Look at Brady's defense. Look at Brady's weapons. Brady went out and he got Gronk and he got Leonard Fournette. Brady clear and Antonio Brown. So you got two things working here with Russell Wilson, who's a top five quarterback. You got teams looking at what Brady did and they want to upgrade at quarterback. That'll solve all our issues. San Francisco's like 26-6 with Garoppolo. Get rid of that bum. We'll never lose another game. Be careful about that. Similarly, I do think you have Aaron Rodgers, Russell Wilson, and others, maybe Deshaun Watson, looking at the New England situation saying, Tommy's getting a little say in personnel, and look at Tommy's weapons, and look at Tommy's defense, and he got Fournette, and he got Gronk, and he got AB. It's the Brady effect. And I think a little bit of that is happening with Russell Wilson, who feels like, listen, man, I don't get any say on personnel. I don't get any say in the playbook. I don't get any say on anything. Did you guys just see what happened in Tampa? I think a lot of this, I think the timing is interesting. It happens after Brady wins a Super Bowl. And Russ is saying, time out. You got Deshaun Watson. I think I'm better than Deshaun. He's forcing the team's hand. You got Tommy got personnel say. I got no personnel say. So I think the timing here is very interesting. I think Russell Wilson needs to be authentic. He's falling into a little trap of being Andrew Luck. And I'm glad he came out on Dan's show and other shows and had strong opinions. You got to be authentic about this stuff. If you're unhappy, say it. But here's the situation in Seattle to me. I think Pete's got too much power. Pete doesn't want to relinquish it. And Russell Wilson has earned the right to say more than go Hawks. He is no longer this plucky, small, unique third-round pick. He's a top five quarterback in this league, running an outdated offense, who has virtually no say. And I'm not saying they've got to be Tampa Bay with Tommy, but he deserves more than he's getting. I think this relationship has gotten more strained as Russell has gotten higher paid and has more power, and that is making some people like Pete Carroll less comfortable. I don't think this is a great relationship. I don't think Russell Wilson's going to get traded. I've been told he's not going to get traded, but it's fluid. It's imperfect. It's turbulent. It's not great. But I'll go back to this, and I really believe it. Why now? Why Russell talking now? It's the Brady effect. Tom went. Tom had power. Tom played GM. Tom almost coached. And Russell's saying, I want a little bit of that. I'm not saying I got to have all of that, but I want a little bit of what Tom's getting because I think I'm in his class. And I don't think he's wrong. All right. So Colin right, Colin wrong.